Along the road ahead lies something you need. However, in order to claim it, you must lose something that is dear to you.
Hey, you think it's okay to barge in?
But we gotta do it, if we can afford the king.
The king? King Mickey's here?
Something just told me he'd be here, okay?
Really? Cause now that you mention it, I was kinda thinking the same thing.
Seriously? Me too. One look at this castle, and I just knew. Our very best friends. They're here.
Yep. Guess great minds think alike.
Wait, hey, hold on. It can't be just a coincidence.
Oh, no, Timothy. You don't mean that.
Yep, I had it too. I had the exact same feeling.
Gorge, maybe it's contagious.
No, something screwy. We gotta go take a look.
All right.
What? Where are you going?
That way, to the door. Are you scared?
Ah, don't be ridiculous. Come on, let's go, Goofy.
Hey, fellers, shouldn't we shut the door behind us before we go? Sora!
That's it. Who are you?
I should think it's obvious. The moment you set foot in this castle, you forgot every spell and every ability you ever knew. In this place, to find is to lose, and to lose is to find. That is the way in Castle Oblivion.
Castle Oblivion?
Here you will meet people that you have known in the past, and you will meet people you miss.
I miss? Riku! You mean Riku's here?
If what you want is to find him,
What'd you do?
I merely sampled your memories, and from them, I made this. To reunite with those you hold dear.
What's this? A card?
It is a promise for the reunion you seek. Hold the card to open the door, and beyond it a new world. Proceed, Sora. To lose and claim anew, or to claim anew only to lose.
Come on, let's go.
Card obtained. Traverse Town. Can I finally talk now? Kinda. Hey everyone, Kamenja here. Welcome to Kingdom Hearts Chain of Memories, aka Cutscene Central. Oh my god, there's so many cutscenes in this game. Well, not really. Yes, there is. It's hard to explain. Let's just get into it. So left stick lets me control the card, X lets me select the card, yada yada yada. Also, welcome to KH Mania, where for the whole month of January, I'll be uploading only Kingdom Hearts starting today. Also, I apologize for not uploading these past few days. Bumpy start to 2019, but don't worry, that's fine, it's okay, this can't be right. This can't be right. Sorry, let me try to get into, the voice. We're in Traverse Town. What you see isn't real. This town is an illusion created by your memories. Can I skip this? Okay, I can. Ingrained in that card. I'm not going to, because this is kind of important. My memories? Forget about that, Sora. We lost Donald and Goofy. Donald? Goofy? Guys, where are you? What do you do of them? They are at the mercy of the cards now. Master the cards, and the strength will be yours again. Okay, tutorial time. I know how to play the game, so I'm going to skip the tutorial for you guys, because it's a bit of a long, winding one. Okay, we're back. Donald, Goofy, hey! Are you two alright? Where have you been? You tell us! When you opened the door, we saw a strange light, and the rest is just blank. Gee, that doesn't help. Try to remember what happened. I have to keep my journal up to date. Hey, Donald, where did I get the new clothes?
What? Me too, Goofy? Somebody's been messing with our clothes.
Could it be the cards again? That is for you to ponder. Master the cards and make your way to the castle. But from here, you walk alone. Alone? We can't let Sora go alone.
Yeah, Sora can't do anything without our help.
Thanks a lot, Donald. You sure you'll be okay?
Of course.
You want me to go alone? Fine, I can take care of myself. The hero speaks boldly. Go then. The rest of Castle Oblivion awaits. Walk the avenues of latent memory, and you shall meet someone dear to you. I've got a bad feeling about this. Relax, Jiminy. I'm ready for any tricks he's got up his sleeve. How hard can it be to figure out these cards? All I have to do is use one in front of that door over there. Oh, buddy. I've been telling myself that for years. I love this game so much, but I'm not that great at it. Music's a bit loud in my ear. I hope that doesn't affect you guys. Traverse Town can perform the following actions in the field. Left stick, move. Right stick, look around. R3, face forward. X to swing your keyblade. Circle to jump. Square to dodge roll. Ugh, God. Striking objects. Yeah. Ugh, give me that. Card obtained. Blizzard. Yeah, the tutorial in this game is the most annoying one because it can't be skipped, so it's like, It's like, this is my 74th time playing this game. I know what I'm doing. Also, I think I've been playing this game longer than it was programmed into existence. If that makes sense. And there we go. Tranquil darkness. To open doors in the field, press triangle. I know, I gotta yawn now, I hope you're happy. Okay. It's just explaining, I'm just gonna skip all of it because I already know it. But essentially it's just telling you that like certain doors require certain criterias of cards. So like if the door says 5, you need a 5, it needs red, you need red, yada yada yada. Okay, essentially there's only one way to get more cards. And it's by defeating Heartless. Well, map cards is by defeating Heartless. Also, so I can finally explain as to why I skipped the title screen and why I didn't do the introduction to the video there. It's because, you know, I've already, I played this a lot. And like, once you beat the main game, the end scene is a bit of a spoiler. So I didn't want to spoil the game for those who hadn't seen it yet. But that's fine. Oh yeah, also when you level up, there's three things you can level up. Your health, the amount of cards you can put into your deck, or slates, which is special abilities you can use in the field. I don't have it right. Cards at the moment, I don't think so. Nope. I don't think so. Oh! There we go, sliding dash. Goofy! Help! There we go. Tranquil darkness again. And he's just gonna go off and then... And I can level up again. I'm gonna go for my health? Or my CP. I'll go for health. Okay. Also, when I said that this game is like cutscene city, oh my god. There's a lot of cutscenes in this game, but it's not like regular cutscenes. Like, you know, like the first one. It's more like the one we just encountered with Mystery Man. Tutorial, so there's a lot like that. So I'm gonna be skipping over a lot of them to get through the game. Because there's a lot of game we gotta get through, and like, there's not a lot of time left until 3 comes out. And like I said, I do wanna play all of them before 3 comes out. So, you know. A majority of the cutscenes I will be skipping. I'm gonna try to keep it as much gameplay as I can, because like, you know, the gameplay of it's very unique. Special cards or crowns, you need special keys, like this, golden keys. I'll get rid of this. I don't really necessarily need that. But I'm also gonna skip mainly the ones we already know about. Okay, and skip. Because we already skipped the first one. There's no point in keeping that one there. Simba. Key of Guidance. So the tutorial is just explaining how to, like, you know, card values and all that. I already know about card values, and it was also explaining about slates, how, like, stacking cards can make slates happen if you had the slate. Yada yada. But let me finish explaining what the first cutscene was. It's basically just, you know, Leon going like, oh, hey. You know, the only reason you're being attacked is because you had the Keyblade. But also he's like, oh, I don't know who you are. And it's like, oh, wait. I don't know who you are, Sora. I was like, wait, you do know us. So, like, how do I know your names? So basically, they don't know who we are, but they know who we are. So it's like a little weird. Translation, I probably shouldn't have skipped the cutscene. But also translation, there's a lot like that. And they just drag on for like 2 minutes. Well, they're going to drag on for like 2 minutes with the way I'm going to be talking about them, so to speak. With the way the speed I'll be talking at, I don't want to talk too fast. But I don't want to talk too slow, either. Ah! No! It's very weird and complex to explain talking. I don't know. I'll shut up. I'm trying to, like, talk here. I'm giving you guys something to work with. I'm weird. I know. Hi, how are you? But yeah, a majority of the cutscenes I'm going to be skipping. If not all of them, the only ones I'm really going to be keeping in the game is the more important Castle Oblivion ones. Because personally, I think those are like the ones to really just like pay attention to. I don't know. I don't want to like have this game stuffed with cutscenes, because this game is stuffed with cutscenes like that. It's just reading. So much reading. That's all it is. It's just so much reading. Hey, also, you're probably wondering, what was the red orb for? That's Moogle Points, which you'll be using to get more cards later on in the game when you unlock a Moogle. Moogle map card. You know, personally speaking, the way they should have done it was that they should have let you, Nope. And you missed. They should have made it so that Moogles can be found in the Castle Oblivion world as well as world map cards. I don't know, that's how I feel that they should have done it. There we go. Marshall Waking. No, don't worry, I'm not going to be reading all the card names. Oh no, I need these Moogle points. Okay. Also, I don't really want to stray from battles, especially early on, because I want to get as many map cards as I can. Because there's also a golden map card, which allows you to get a certain treasure in each world. And because I already beat the game, I don't remember if, because I know that, like, when you beat the game, like, you can go back to other worlds and, use the gold map card for it. Because each world has a treasure room. And, like, the first time you go through it, you'll get one treasure, right? But once you beat it, the second time you go back, there's going to be a different treasure. Once you get those two treasures, afterwards, it'll just be a random card. Essentially, those two treasures are very important. The treasure room is, somewhere over here. It's this one right here. It's marked on the map for you can see it easier. Which I like, it's nice. Also, I apologize, again, I didn't really say it that well earlier, but I just want to apologize. Sorry, hold on. I need some water. Hold on. Sorry, I needed water. My throat was killing me. But I'd like to say... What was I going to say? I forgot what I was going to say. Oh, okay. So I like to, first off, not the right video to do it, but I'm too lazy to do a vlog this week. I'd just like to apologize for not uploading these past few days. They've been a bit hectic for me. You know, with work, a birthday. There's a lot went on, so I'd like to apologize. And also like to apologize for not uploading two videos a day like I said I was. But for the month, I'm going to definitely try it. I don't want to say... Well, I want to at least make an attempt. But the thing is, I don't want to upload like two videos of this game a day, you know? Oops, key of guidance is what I need. Well, I done goofed up. It's back here. Oops. Okay. You know, I was actually really bent on doing two videos a day, but I was like, nah. Okay, I'm gonna skip this because it's just, essentially, it's just the Traverse Town crew saying, oh, hey, this is our first time meeting, but we know your names, and we know who you are, and that it's this town. They're basically trying to, like, talk about Castle Oblivion's effect on the people, on the gang. Ah, no! And how essentially they're losing their memories. And stuff like that. Well, they're not really losing their memories per se. Well, they are, but... It's a little difficult to explain. The story will explain it a lot better. They didn't necessarily lose it. They're not necessarily losing their memories, but... I'm actually not good at explaining this. Let me try to explain this, though. Well, spoilers. So because of Castle Oblivion, because they lost their abilities are not the only thing they're losing. They're losing their memories. And the deeper they go into Castle Oblivion, which is where we are, of course, the more memories they're going to lose of the people they met. So, they're kind of going back to the worlds they've traversed through. And they're kind of gaining new memories with people who aren't even there. It's just you meeting Sid, and he's just going to go through the same thing. And then this guy appears. Hello! Then this guy shows up to cause havoc. Ow. Ooh, I need that. What fell out? I need that. Oh, it's goofy. Freeze. Oh, I missed. First of all, how dare you? Oh, that was silly. Damn it! Ow, I missed it. And I'm sorry if you guys actually want to see the cutscenes, but between me and you, I kind of don't because they're like long as hell, and like I know I shouldn't skip them, but we're like, Kingdom Hearts 3 comes out in a few weeks, and we're still on part 1.5 of all games, you know? And like I said, I really want to play all the games on the channel before 3 comes out. That didn't help me at all. There we go. So yeah, Calm. I'm gonna like just skip cutscenes, but I'm not gonna skip the important ones. Oops. There he goes. Off to you know where. And we got a card for defeating the boss. Ah. Guard armor. But yeah, like, you know, I'm only gonna skip cutscenes like this that aren't as important to the main story of Kingdom Hearts Chain of Memories. That's really all I'll be skipping. So don't worry. I know you're like, oh, but well, I want to know about the sky. I want to know about that too, Jay. Come on. Trust me, it's not as important to the actual main storyline as you think it is. It's kind of like Chi. The mobile game? Yeah. It's kind of like that. It's kind of like a mission. One of the random-ass missions that aren't actually relevant to the story itself. But are just there. It's there to be there, you know? Also, yes, I'll be doing one world, one level per video. Which means this video is almost over.
Well, Sora, did you enjoy meeting your memories?
Yeah, it was good to see everyone. But what do you really want from me?
What do you have to give?
Hello.
What do you want?
No hogging the hero.
Then perhaps you'd like to test him.
Perhaps I would. My show now, Keyblade Master. Who am I? Oh, my name's Axel. Got it memorized?
Sure.
Good. You're a quick learner. So, Sora, now that we're getting to know each other better... Don't you go off and die on me now.
Axel! Yeah, they also do this a lot. After every world, you'll fight a boss, and then they'll have you fight another boss. So it's like, oh, okay, that's cool. That's cool. Ow. Please don't hit him with fire. Thank you, Donald. Thank you. Because, yeah, if you hit him with fire, he does gain health back. And Donald loves to hit him with fire sometimes. It's not great. It's not great. It's not great. It's not great. Level up. And a card. Fire. Fire good. Fire good. Card obtained. fire. I'm going to go and upgrade my CP. It's always a hard choice between your health and CP.
Another one? What's it do?
Kind of looks like the card you used when you made Traverse Town.
Then I guess we're gonna need it to keep going.
That's right.
Action!
Did you really think after that introduction I would give up oh so easily?
You were testing us.
And you passed. Congratulations, Sora. You're ready now. Ready to take on Castle Oblivion. You will need to follow your memories. Trust what you remember and seek what you forget. Then you will find someone very special.
You mean King Mickey and Riku?
You will just have to give some more thought to who it is that's most important to you. Our most precious memories lie so deep within our hearts that they're out of reach. But I'm sure that you can find yours, Sora.
Why me?
You have lost sight of the light within the darkness, and it seems that you've forgotten that you forgot.
The light within darkness?
Would you like me to give you a hint?
Sora, do you need it?
I'm gonna figure it out for myself. If you're in my way...
Don't worry, Sora. We'll protect you.
Good answer. Just what I'd expect from the Keyblade Master. But be forewarned. When your sleeping memories awaken, you may no longer be who you are now.
Card obtained! Agrabah, Olympus... Ah, I was reading that! Well, too late. Okay, so that about wraps it up for episode 1, moving to another floor erases all the rooms you've created. If you return to this floor later, you'll need to make new rooms using new map cards. That's fine. I'll come back here later. Another cutscene. Great.
What's wrong, Jiminy?
Well, you see, what Axel said back there worries me. What could he have meant by, you may no longer be who you are?
I may no longer be me. How can I be anyone else?
Of course. Still, you can't be too careful.
Yep. Feels like just about anything could happen here in Castle Oh, yeah. Now I remember.
We'll be okay. Whatever it is they're cooking up, we'll be able to handle it together.
Course we will. Like that creepy castle we explored together. The one with all those weird contraptions.
When was that?
I can't remember. What was it called?
Gorge. Oh, it was, Holly? Holler? Sorry, I can't remember.
What? Stop goofing around.
Goofy, sure you didn't make it up?
I don't think so.
Ooh! The swirling spear in front of Sora is called Warp Point. You can freely move to and from floors that you've already completed. Stand near it and press triangle to open the world map warp menu. Thank you, I gotta end the video. Anyways, thank you all so much for watching. That is basically a good example of what's happening to everyone in the castle. They're going to forget everything that happened outside of the castle, and they're going to only remember what's happening inside the castle. Castle Oblivion. So, thank you all so much for watching. Hope y'all enjoyed. Hope to see y'all on the next one. Stay awesome, everyone. Laters! Always important to save as often as possible. As often and regularly as possible.